Hey guys, gonna do a quick video today. I had commented on one of John NYC CNC's videos a little while back. He had gotten a bunch of purchases at an auction, and in some of those lots he had gotten a set of corner rounding end mills. And I commented on that video to him that he was really going to like them if he'd never used them before. That's what one of them looks like. So it allows you to put a nice radius or corner round on a part. And, you know, if you're a woodworker, you probably know these as, you know, end over bits or something like that. They're not the same, so please don't use a router bit to do this kind of work in machine work. But they're really handy to have. They look great on a product. They can be a pain in the butt as far as time consumption if you're doing manual machining and a bunch of parts to do. But they're great. They are expensive. So I commented to John on that, and you know, I said, you love them, and he asked me a couple of questions about how I use them, you know, and I said, I'll try and do a quick video. I know other people have done this, but I'll do one here on doing it manually and show you guys a little bit. So just a little close up here. So here's one of those corner rounding end mills again. This one is a quarter inch radius. I don't know if you can read that. Probably not. So it's kind of what it looks like. That's what we're going to be using today. Here's a part I had in my scrap bin that I had, I don't know, a base for something. I can't remember what it was. But it has the corners cut. I think you can see that. So you can see what I'm talking about. This is just a piece of aluminum, some base I had or whatever. But you can see what we're going to be doing here. And that was, this plate had a quarter inch radius on it. So it's a nice aesthetic finish to a part. Makes it look real nice. I'll show you how it's done. Alright, here we go. I just got a piece of aluminum, and we're going to use that as our test piece. It's whatever, roughly 3¾ by 4 inches, and it is 3/8 thick material. We're going to be putting that quarter inch radius on the edge, so we got plenty. We're not going to get a full radius on this part, obviously, because it's 3/8. And I'm going to go ahead and use the factory edges. I love using thick parallels, by the way. That's what I always use. I don't use thins if I can get away with it. And I'm going to let this hang out a bit because, you know, if you look up at our tool here, I got a little bit of a hangover or hang on it. So I can't come right up to the edge of my part. I'm going to let it hang past the vise a little bit. Let's see, our tool's a little under an inch in diameter. So if I give myself half inch stick out, I'm plenty fine and still gonna be plenty supported here. Tighten up our vise. Seat our part a bit. Kind of awkward to get in there with the camera there. Alright, I got you sort of lined up here. You're on the looking straight back in the y-axis, and I got a little bit of a light here. Trying not to wash out the camera, but I do want you to see how I'm going to set this up, because really the hardest part about using one of these is just setting up your zeros where it makes sense. So move around. So I'm towards the front edge of the part, and I've put my just head in neutral here for a second, and I'm just lining up this one flute here. And what I want to do is I'm going to turn the machine on, and I'm just going to touch, let me get a pointer here, let me get my scale.
What I want to do is touch off on the top of the part, but really with the smallest part of this tool that I can. So really just this outermost edge, I want to come do a touch off on the edge of the part. So I'm even overhanging more than I need to right now. When I put that up, you can see how little of a landing pad I really want to touch off on this part. I hope you can see it. It's kind of tricky to set the camera up to see that. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to come touch off on the top of the part, and I'm going to call that Z0. So let's do that real quick. Let's see, get myself in gear here. Go. And I can run this just about 1,000 RPM. That's going to be fine for us. So just coming and touching. Right there. So, pop that into neutral again so you guys can see. I just barely touched the edge of the part. I'm not sure you're going to be able to see it, but I've just dusted it. Just barely dusted it. And what I was doing is, you know, I have my feed engaged and I'm using my handle here to come and give myself control. The gears aren't engaged, they're disengaged, right? Disengaged to the left, disengaged. So it's not auto feeding the spindle down, it just gives me that control. So, you know, I'm lucky enough to have a Prototrack retrofit. It's from the early 90s, so no fancy display or anything, but it does give me a Z readout from a quill readout. So I can go Z absolute set, and now I know I'm at Z0 for the quill. You can do the same thing by locking your quill and using your knee, bringing up and zeroing out your knee. It's fine. Here's the critical step. So we're touching just now on that edge, the leftmost edge of the tool. It's just touching the Z. Here's the critical step. Come up. Bring your knee, you know, down, or your quill up, whatever you're using. About 3 thou. So I'm going to bring mine. I got my left hand on my handle here. 3 thou. I raised it. So I raised it up 3 thou. Brought it up 3 thou. And I'm going to zero it again. That's my zero. So what this does is when I come and actually make my cut and I go to zero, it's going to be just slightly proud of the surface by a couple of thousandths, 3 thousandths in our case. And what that's going to do is remove that really unsightly line sometimes you'll get in a part from just going a hair too deep. So that's really the trick in using these. So now, bring myself up. We can do the exact same process, except with the x-axis now. I'm still neutral. We just want to touch off this part of the tool at the topmost part of the side of the part as we can get away with to establish that touch off. And then we'll call that zero, back off about 3 thousandths, and call it zeroed again. And then we'll know where we're at. So let's do that real quick. Get myself in gear.
So I did that fast. It's just a touch. So again,
use our readout. X absolute.
And then I want to come off the part. I'll exaggerate. I want to come off the part in this direction.
About 3 thou. X absolute. That's our 0 point.
That's the trick in this whole thing, is setting that 0. All right, let me reset. I'll come right back.
Okay, I got you handheld for a minute. I'm going to just show you what I'm doing here. So we're going to cut a set up to take our first cut. I'm going to start about 50 thousandths high on the Z and about 50 thousandths away on the X. So I got an even cut. It's not that critical. And what we'd be doing is knocking the edge, the sharp edge off of the top of the part with the inner circle. I don't know if you guys can see that. I think the camera's washing you out. So I'm thinking we're just barely going to touch here, and if we're not cutting, then we'll come in and move ourselves in a bit. All right. So let's give it a whirl. Right around 1100, 1150, something like that for this size. I'm just going to feed manually. Just taking that edge off. It's really just, it's the equivalent of a rough and pass. So we really just hit that top edge of the part there. I know you're kind of far away here. Let me see if I can pop you off and put you here. Nope, not going to work. About on a 1-2-3 block. How about another one? That works. So that just dusted that edge. Now it's important to remember that corner rounding end mills do not like to climb. Do not climb with them. At least that's my experience. They don't have the relief to do that. So we'll go ahead and take another pass. I'll probably come in and I'll take 20 thou off of each, so we'll be 30 thou off our final, and just see what that looks like. 30. That's going to be a heftier cut there. And let's see how you guys do on that shot. Kind of a heavy cut, but again, it's aluminum, and yeah, I was feeding a little fast and dry and all that stuff, but again, I'm not too concerned about that. Let's get you a little bit higher. Really get you in on the action. Yeah, that's pretty rough. So I'll do two things this time to help out on that. I'm only going to take let's see, we were 30 thou away, right? We'll bring ourselves to 20, so we'll take 10. But it's not exactly 10 from each side because it's on that radius. And I'll give you a little WD-40 playtime. that should help. And let's go ahead and take another cut. Was a much smoother cut. The WD-40 really helps a lot in aluminum. If you're cutting aluminum dry, try some WD-40. You'll be amazed how big of a difference that makes. It's almost silky smooth. I've been feeding this manually, just with the crank. Now I have the option of using a machine feed on the Y since I have the Pertitrack retrofit, and we'll do that on the last pass, and that'll just give it a very consistent result. So we're going to do two more passes. We're 20 thou away. We'll go ahead and come to 10 thou away. Were we 10? We were 10. Alright, sorry, lost track there. So we'll go 5 off, 5 thousandths off. And we'll cut once more freehand, and then we'll do a final pass with the machine feed. Looking good. Just setting this up real quick. That's 10 inches a minute. It's a little fast for the finish, but it's easy to set up right now. So we're going to use that. And we're only, again, this is our final pass, 5 thou, down in the Z and over in the X. And that's where we're going to run it. Go. That's the final pass. So the final pass to dimension was 2
X0, Z0, which remember were about 3 thou proud of the top surface and the side surface. And when you do that, what you do is you get a nice radius here and you don't get any of those really rough edges. So that cut's pretty nice. I mean, it's pretty smooth. If you really wanted it buttery smooth, you could turn your feed rate way down or a slow controlled manual feed for your final pass. But I hope you guys can see that. I mean, you can see the light reflecting off of the radiused edge we just made right there, as opposed to sort of the factory as milled finishes, or excuse me, as extruded finishes, edges. And there it is. There you go. Buttery smooth. So that's how you cut a radius, using a radius cutting end mill. If you were doing, you know, sides of a plate, you definitely want to set a stop. If I had a stop set on the lower part of the plate, I could flip this around and, you know, taking my roughing passes and then coming in my finish, I would come to the exact same location, which is important if you want your corners to match up. If you don't get everything, if you don't have the same depth of cut exactly on every side of a plate, for instance, the mitered, if you will, corners, when they come together, aren't going to look right. So in this part, they look pretty good. If you were off even by maybe two, three thou, you would notice this edge and this edge, these false edges, if you will, won't come together perfectly, and you can see it. So you really got to pay attention and sort of get your touch-off technique the same, so it's always the same. So that's how you do it. That's how you cut a radius with a radius cutting end mill. All right, see you guys a little later.